Hey there. So traveling on a budget can be really tricky. I know it is because trust me, I've tried. And unfortunately, I'm the type of person to buy every little trinket that I find along the way. I know you're wondering, so what? Well, if I'm on a budget, then obviously I'm cutting into my traveling expenses. So I was inspired to find a working solution for everyone who had the same predicament and they love to travel. Welcome to Lexi's Diaries. I'm your ever traveling host, Alexandria, or just Lexi. Today, we look at beautiful Kenya, the land filled with such untold beauty. If you don't believe me, just look at the Safaricom ad or do me one better and just show up. And why not? The people are friendly, the country absolutely amazing, and the food is to die for. There's literally tons of stuff to do. I come from Kenya, but honestly, I was spoiled for choice when I decided to hit the road with my friends with nothing but a backpack and an amount of money that's honestly embarrassing to quote in public, let alone national TV. So we'll just leave that one alone. Anyway, back to choices. You may be wondering, what am I talking about? Especially if you're Kenyan, because a lot of us take our country for granted and we end up vacationing everywhere else but at home. Well, east or west, home is best. At least for me, it is. Now, I know why my friends call me Backtrack Lex, but let's move on. Choices, yeah. We have the magnificent Rift Valley. It cuts right across the eastern part of the country and it's quite the sight to behold. Think about a huge, gigantic, endless crater and imagine yourself standing right at the edge of it. Simply exhilarating. You know, it's really funny. A lot of people who live in the developed world think Africa is a jungle, lions, elephants and loincloths. Well, some of that is true. We do have jungles, just not everywhere. We have lions, that's true too, but it's important to be clear on the rest. We do wear clothes, okay people? But on a serious note, we have a lot of wildlife and we are proud of it. The opportunities to see the wildlife are there and remarkably affordable. What's best, and I really, really like this about Kenya, most animal parks or sanctuaries actually let the kids under 12 pay either a subsidized rate or half price. How awesome is that? Anyway, if lions and giraffes and cheetahs lazing under the acacia trees in the long savanna grass don't tickle your fancy, don't worry. We have sandy beaches with ocean just stretching endlessly before you in the Kenyan coast. That's just the place for you. And if you're a history buff like me, then the rich history in the coastal towns of Lamu and Malindi will just amaze you. The architecture has loads of Arab influence and it becomes quickly evident that some of their culture and language has been derived from Arabic. Well, are you still a doubting Thomas or have I made a believer out of you? Well, I know the sporty guys are thinking, what about us? There's tons to do. You can go whitewater rafting, surfing, diving, and if you're an adrenaline junkie and you're thinking, this is so not exciting for me, well, we have the Rhino Supercharged Challenge, which is for charity, but honestly, it's hair-raising and quite fun. Whatever your cup of tea is, Kenya's the land for it.